everyone. I'm Katrina, and in this video, I'm going to go over how to change the color of one menu item in WordPress when you're using a Genesis Child theme. So here we are on my website. In this video, I'm going to be using the Executive Pro Genesis Child theme, and we can see this is what the website looks like. As a side note, if you'd like to know how to put this entire website together, I did create another video on my YouTube channel that walks you step-by-step from scratch to show you how to set up and customize the Executive Pro Genesis Child theme. So I'll be sure to drop a link to that video down below so you can check it out. So here we are back on our website, and when we left off in the previous video on the Executive Pro Genesis Child Theme video tutorial, we left off with our menu navigation items looking just like this. Now, this is actually a really great way to leave your menu navigation items if you'd like. So if this is where you're at and you just want to leave them like that, then you're good to go. There may be occasions, however, when you have a menu navigation item that you also want to have serve as a call to action, and you want to have it pop out and stand out and draw your visitors' attention toward it so that they take an action. So for example, in this particular situation right here, we have a contact menu item, and in the event that I want this to really stand out, then we can change the style of this particular item and leave all the other ones consistent over here on the left-hand side. So to show you where we're headed toward in this video, when we're finished with this video, we're going to have one item right here that instead of looking like all the other items, instead it's going to pop out and it's going to have a different style and color attached to it. So this is where we're headed in this video. We're going to be changing one menu item in your Genesis framework, Genesis Child theme in WordPress. So let's get started. So to change the color of one menu item in your Genesis Child theme, it's a two-step process. Step number one, we need to create a CSS class for that unique menu item. And step number two, we need to change the CSS styles of the CSS class that we just created. So let's take care of step number one, which is creating the new CSS class for our menu item. To do that, you want to go to the dashboard, then scroll down to Appearance, hover over Appearance, and then click on Menus to go to the Menus page. Here on the Menus page, we'll see all the different menu items that I've already added to my website, and the style that I want to change in this video is the style for the contact menu navigation item right here. So when I open this by clicking on open, we'll see here we have the navigation label, the title attribute, and that's pretty much all we have. So we need to display the CSS class. To do that, you want to scroll up to the top, click on screen options, and in your Genesis Child theme, you should see an advanced menu property here that says CSS classes. So I'm going to click on that to activate this, and then I'm going to close my screen options by just clicking on screen options once again to collapse the panel. Now when I scroll down to my contact menu navigation item, now we see we have an extra field right here for the CSS classes. So our first step after activating this is we need to create a CSS class for the contact navigation item. So I'm going to add my class right there. I'm just going to call this contact-nav. There's no spaces here, all one word pretty much. And then note that I am creating a class specifically for the contact navigation item. If you want to create a class for one of the other items, of course you can call that something else. So for example, if you want to create a class for the about page because you want to style that as well, then you would create maybe about-nav or give it another unique class label. Okay, so here we are on my contact menu navigation item. I have my CSS class right there. Next, I'm just going to scroll to the top and click on Save Menu to save my menu with my new CSS class. Once the menu navigation item has been updated, now we can check it out by going to the home page by clicking on Visit Site. Here on the homepage of my website, on the right-hand side, we can see our contact menu navigation item, but as we see, nothing really has changed related to the styles. So we've completed step number one, which is creating the CSS class for this particular menu navigation item. Step number two is we need to create a CSS style to go with it. So I am in Google Chrome, the Google Chrome browser, and I'm going to be using a developer tool called Inspect Elements. Here in Google Chrome, when you go to the top right-hand side, you'll see there are three lines, which when I click on these, it gives me a new panel. Then I'm going to scroll down to Tools, and then I'm going to click on Developer Tools to open up the Inspect Elements tool so I can see the behind the scenes code that is generating all the styles on my homepage and on my website. On the left-hand side, we have all the HTML code right here. These are all the different codes that are creating the layout for the website. And on the right-hand side are all of the CSS styles that are creating the styles for the website. Things like colors, fonts, font sizes, font styles, and things like that. So we need to find the element that is related specifically to the contact menu item right here. So I'm just going to drill down one by one until I find the style related to the contact menu navigation item. So here in the Inspect Elements panel, we can see that I found the contact nav CSS class we just created in the previous step. And when I hover over this particular line of code, we can see that it highlights in the background on the actual website. We can see that this element is highlighted. So we know we are in the right spot. On the right-hand side here on this column, we can see all of the different CSS styles that are creating the styles currently for this menu navigation item as well as the other menu navigation items up above. So in order to customize this particular style, we have to add a new custom style for the contact nav menu navigation item so that it replaces the default styles that are showing up here on the right-hand side. So let's do that now. I'm going to go back to my website here. I'm going to go back to the dashboard. Here on the dashboard, the next step is we need to customize the CSS styles in our custom style sheet. So to do that, I'm going to go down to Appearance, hover over Appearance, and click on Editor. Here on the Edit Themes page, we'll see a number of different files that make up our child theme, including the style sheet style.css file and a custom.css file. So in my previous video, where I showed you step-by-step from scratch how to create this website using the Executive Pro Child theme, in that video, I showed you also how to create a custom style sheet. Whenever we are creating styles or customized styles to our Genesis Child theme, it's really important to make sure you have a custom style sheet so that in the event the developer updates your theme, your custom styles will not be overwritten. So if you do not yet see a custom.css file, then I'm going to refer you to my other video where you can see how to create a customized style sheet and get that set up and ready to go. Once you have your custom style sheet ready to go, go ahead and click on custom.css, and here we can safely add the styles that we'll be adding to the menu navigation item. So I'm just going to scroll down and I'm going to add my custom style sheet file styles at the bottom here, keeping in mind that the CSS class that we created in the previous step was contact-nav. So for that class, in order to create this particular style, we want to start off with a dot, and then I'm just going to add contact-nav right here to indicate that I want to make a style change to this particular item. So here it reads dot contact-nav, there's a space and an opening bracket. Then I'm going to add a background color right here, background and a colon, and a pound sign, and then I have a color code right here, and then I'll add a semicolon. So the other thing that I want to add here is I want to kind of round out the corners of this particular navigation item so that it has a kind of button look to it, a button, it looks like a button. So in order to add rounded corners, we want to use another CSS code here, which is called border-radius. And I'm going to give this a radius of 5 pixels, and I'm going to finish it with a semicolon. So this is the code that we're adding. Make sure that you do have an opening and a closing bracket, and each line of code needs a semicolon at the end. So I'll be sure to drop this code in the video in the event you can't read it directly here, right here. Once you have the code ready to go ahead and click on Update File to update your file. Okay, so once the file has been updated successfully, we can check it out by going up to the top and clicking on Visit Site. And here we see the button effect that has been created for this one item. Now there's a couple more changes that I want to create for this particular item, starting with the font color. We can see that it's a gray color over a turquoise background, so I'd rather have that be a white font color. So let's change that first. I'm going to go up to the top, I'm going to hover over this particular item, and on my Mac, I'm actually going to open up Inspect Elements in a faster, easier way this time. So instead of clicking on these three lines. I'm going to hover over this particular item, and then on my Mac, I'm going to hold down the Control key and then click my mouse button. This will open up the panel directly, and I can go directly to Inspect Element. If you're on a PC, you can do the same thing by right-clicking when you're hovering over this particular item, and then you can click on Inspect Element that way. Okay, so I'm going to click on Inspect Element to open up this panel. Then, just as we did in the previous step, on the right-hand side, we see all of the different styles for this particular item. Here, when I click on the list item right here, we can see here are the two new customized styles we've added, .contact-nav, and we have our background and our border radius. So the next step is I want to change the font color from this gray color to a white color. So to do that, we need to click on the A right here, because this is where it says contact. And then note that here is the default color is this 6666 number, this gray color, and it says .genesis-nav-menu, and there's an A. So for us in this particular item, we note that our class is the .contact-nav, so we need to create another set of codes. This time it will say .contact-nav space A. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that now. So I'm going to close this and go back to the dashboard. Here on the dashboard, once again, I'm going to go down to Appearance, hover over Appearance, and click on Editor. Then I'm going to go directly to custom.css, scroll to the bottom, and I'm going to add a new style to this particular item right here. So once again, I'm going to add .contact-nav, and this time I'm going to add a space and an A. The A references a link, then another space, an opening bracket, and this time I'm going to add a color code of white, which is pound and then six Fs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, closing it with a semicolon and a closing bracket. So this is the color code that we can add for the actual font color on that button. So then I'm just going to click on Update File to update my file. Then I'm going to go back to the site to check it out by clicking on Visit Site. And now we can see that the color looks so much better. It's a lot easier to read with white on turquoise. Now the other thing we need to change here, note that when I hover over this item, the whole button disappears, which I really don't want. I want that button to stay intact whether I'm activating it or whether I'm hovering over it. So once again, I'm going to create another CSS style by opening up Inspect Elements to check it out. Here we can see I'm directly on the item, and when I hover over this particular item code right here, and once again, I'm going to hold down my Control key on a Mac and click on the actual mouse keypad right here. Once again, we get another drop-down features, all these different features we can check out, including force element state. So this is the one that I want. I'm going to force the element state to be hover, so I'm just going to click on that. And then, let's see, here we can see there's a little yellow indication here that this is being selected. So looking on the right-hand side here, we can see the styles that are creating the default styles for the hover effect on this particular contact menu navigation item. So as we see here, it says .genesis-nav-menu, and then there's a space, an A, then there's a colon, and it says hover. Then we see the background color is white with the font color of this gray color right here. So this is the code that we're going to need to change and customize the hover effect on this particular menu navigation item. So just keeping in mind in the back of my head this A colon hover code right there, I'm just going to make a mental note of that, and then I'm going to go back to my dashboard by clicking on the back button. Then here on the dashboard, once again, I'm going to go down to Appearance, hover over Appearance, and click on Editor. Next, I'm going to go to the custom.css file and click on that. And then at the bottom, as we did in the previous steps, I'm going to add my custom code for the hover effect. So as we did in the previous example, I'm going to add my CSS class first, .contact-nav, and then I'm going to add this A, just the A, and then colon, and then it will say hover, space, opening bracket. Now I can add the background color as well as the font color. Okay, so here we have the completed code. I have .contact-nav space, Then I have the A. The A indicates a link, and then colon hover indicates this is going to be the style when we hover over this particular link. The background is going to be a different shade of the turquoise. We can see here that the color code is a little bit different, and it starts with a pound and ends with a semicolon, and then the actual font color on top of this button is the color code of white, which are 6 Fs. Followed by a semicolon, and then once again we have our closing bracket right here. So once again, I'll drop this code in the video so you can read it a little bit better. When you have that ready to go, go ahead and click on Update File to update your file. Now when we go back up to the site to check it out by clicking on Visit Sites, and now we can see on the right hand side we have one customized menu navigation item with a button effect, which when I hover over this particular item, the contact item right here, we see that it turns a different shade of the turquoise background color. So this is how you change the color of one menu item in your Genesis Child theme. I hope this video was helpful to you. If it was, please feel free to leave a comment below, like the video, and share this video with your friends. I will be coming out with more videos related to WordPress, Genesis, and how to grow your business on the web. So please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Last but not least, all the conversation continues on my website at 77webstudio.com, so feel free to head on over to my website to continue the conversation. One more thing before I sign off, I want to mention that I've recently created a Facebook page for 77 Web Studio where I'll be sharing videos, posts, and articles related to growing an online business, Genesis, and WordPress. So if you are on Facebook, like many of us are, feel free to head on over to facebook.com/77webstudio to join our Facebook community. Also, if you're on Twitter, feel free to connect with me at 77 Web Studio. Until next time, I hope you have a great week and continue learning new skills that help you to build your business on the web.